Hey guys, welcome back to Flipped Psychology. I'm so glad that you made your way back. We are starting a brand new unit in this video, the biopsychology domain. And this is a really large unit, but we're going to take it step by step. And first off, we're going to start with our nervous system. So if you haven't done so already, go ahead and grab your notes and let's get started. Objectives that we're going to be covering today are going to be to identify and discuss the functions of the central nervous system. So, to understand how our nervous system operates, you need to understand kind of the layout of the land, so to speak. First off, our nervous system is electrochemical. There are two ways that the messages get transmitted throughout our body, and one of them is electrical and one of them is chemical. We're going to talk all about that as we go. Messages are sent from the axon terminals of one neuron to the dendrites of other neurons. In a few moments, I'm going to show you what this looks like, but just understand they are sent away through the axon and to the next neuron through the dendrites. So what I want you to do is right now, before we go on, this is something I do with every class. I want you to put your fingers up in the air and I want you to wiggle them and I want you to say in the silliest way you can, dendrites! And this is how the next neuron will receive the message through the dendrites! And I hope I actually see you doing this during our Unit 2 test because there will be opportunities. Okay, another important thing to remember about how messages travel through neurons is that messages travel in one direction and are received by the dendrites and travel through the cell body and the axon to the axon terminal. So it's very predictable and it happens the exact same way every time. From there, the messages cross a synapse to the dendrites of other neurons, okay? So it's very much like plumbing when it works like it's supposed to. When you flush a toilet, so think about flushing a toilet, when you press the lever down, the water is going to go in one direction. Water isn't going to come into the bowl, it's going to go away from the bowl. So this is very much how a neuron will transmit a message to the next neuron. It's not going to come back in a different direction. It's a one-way only street. So here we see the anatomy of two neurons. First, we're going to, and I'm going to use my cursor, we're going to look at this part of the neuron. This is where we're going to start. These are the dendrites. This is where dendrites receive the message, okay? And they're going to travel in one direction down to the cell body and into the nucleus. The nucleus is what's going to determine whether that is something important to transmit. Here are the other parts of the neuron as we travel down. And again, kind of pretend like we are the message or my cursor is the message. It's going to travel in one direction down the axon, okay? It's going to travel down the axon away from the cell body so that it can leave that neuron and go into the next neuron. The message is going to travel across a tiny, tiny, tiny little gap called a synapse. A couple other parts of the neuron that you need to know, the myelin sheath. This is very much like if you've ever seen the inside of some wiring. The myelin sheath is that protective covering that's going to keep the electrical message, like from the wall to your lamp, that is an electrical message. And it's going to keep the electricity inside the cord so that you don't get shocked or so that that electricity stays where you want it to go. So the myelin sheath acts like that plastic or rubber protective covering of the cord. So the axon is covered with myelin sheath, and then the message is going to travel down the axon to the axon terminals. And again, that message is going to then become chemical and leave the first neuron through the synapse via neurotransmitters. These are chemicals. They're going to be received by the dendrites of the next neuron. So let's talk about neurotransmitters. They are super important and they're really, really important in psychology because every condition, as we're finding out, that mental illnesses are almost always related somehow to something being off with the neurotransmitters. So they're involved in everything that we do, these neurotransmitters, these chemicals. Some diseases or psychological disorders can be caused by the presence of too many or too few. So something is off. We sometimes refer to that as a chemical imbalance. And there are many, many types of neurotransmitters. We usually only talk about six in psychology, but there's over 100 neurotransmitters. And each has its own structure and fits into a receptor made specifically for it on the next neuron, on that dendrite, okay? So I want you to think of it like a lock and key, and I have an illustration of that on your screen. It acts just like a lock and a key. The lock is on the dendrite. It is going to only receive certain keys, the neurotransmitters, okay? So there is a receptor site that is going to be specific to a certain kind of neurotransmitter. And here is what this looks like. So if you follow again my cursor, here you're going to see the action potential, and that's the message being sent through the neuron. These terminal buttons, these are the end points of the axon, and it's what's going to release the neurotransmitters. Here is a close-up of that tiny, tiny, tiny little synaptic gap. And this is the difference between one neuron and the next neuron. So here's the dendrite of the receiving neuron and these specific receptor sites. They're only going to accept neurotransmitters that they are made for. So the central nervous system is made up of two parts, the neurons of the spinal cord and the brain. So we're looking at the spinal cord and the brain. This is the central nervous system, and I like to use the metaphor of a highway system. These make up the I-40 or the I-10 or one of these large highway systems that many, many cars travel on. It's large. It's very important. If you have an accident or a problem on one of these highways, it's a really big deal. So let's start with the neurons of the spinal cord. First of all, they carry the messages between the brain and the muscles and glands in the rest of the body. So this is like the big part of the highway system. The neurons are also involved in spinal reflexes. These are reflexes that don't even involve the brain. Your spinal cord can kind of intervene and make a decision. So if you put your hand on a hot surface, you don't have to consider whether that's going to burn you or not and then make the decision to pull your hand away. It's a reflex. So the spinal cord has actually intervened in that message and sent the message back to the hand to pull away and not get burned. So one way that I always remember the parts of the central nervous system is that all of the central nervous system is covered by bone. The brain is covered by the skull, and the neurons of the spinal cord are protected by the bones of the spine. Then we have the peripheral nervous system. So these are the smaller systems on our highway metaphor, and they're responsible for transmitting messages between the central nervous system, that spinal cord and brain, and all the rest of the part of the body, and it's made up of somatic and autonomic nervous system. So there's like two subparts to the peripheral nervous system. The somatic nervous system transmits sensory messages, things that you touch, things that you feel, the temperature in the air, when you taste something, when you smell something. So when we have a sensation of our outside environment, the somatic nervous system is going to transmit that to the brain. The autonomic nervous system regulates things that you don't really have to have any control over, like heartbeat and breathing. So the body's vital functions, they are all covered by your autonomic nervous system. And the mnemonic that I remember the autonomic through is that the autonomic is automatic. You don't have to think about making your heartbeat. You don't have to think about, believe it or not, blinking. I am now, but you don't have to remember to blink. If you're in the middle of a conversation, you just blink. You don't have to remember to breathe when you're asleep. So these are all controlled through the autonomic nervous system. And that's pretty much it for our nervous system. It's a lot of information. It's very dense. It's very important that you remember. But what we covered in this video is the function of the central and peripheral nervous systems and the functions of our neurons, the way that neurons transmit messages throughout our body. Our next video will cover section 2, which is the brain and how we study it. I can't wait to see you then. Bye for now.